Hello everyone, this is Ruchi Kulkarni. Today we will do Reach for the Top Part 2 Maria Sharapova from Class 9 book Beehive. Maria Sharapova, born on 19th April 1987, is a Russian former world number 1 tennis player. She became number 1 for the first time on 22nd August 2005 at the age of 18. She won 5 Grand Slam titles, 2 at French Open, 1 each at the Australian Open, Wimbledon and US Open, winning 36 titles in total. She was also considered one of the greatest rivals of Serena Williams. She had also won a silver medal at the 2012 London Olympics. Such is the success story of Maria. But to reach that top, it required a lot of sacrifice and persistent willpower, which she truly showed. To get a glimpse of her life, let's read and understand part 2 of the chapter Reach for the Top, after which we will do significance of the title, moral, summary and question answers. Let's begin with reading and explanation. A Russian girl, Maria Sharapova, reached the summit of women's tennis when she was barely 18. As you read about her, see if you can draw a comparison between her and Santosh Yadav. In this part of the chapter, we are going to read about the hard work, determination, and the sacrifices made by Maria Sharapova to become the number one women's tennis champion. In the first part of this chapter, we learned about Santosh Yadav and her share of hard work. Now, as we move along this chapter, let's try to draw a comparison between Maria Sharapova and Santosh Yadav and see how closely related they are in terms of their determination, hard work, and success. There is something disarming about Maria Sharapova, something at odds with her ready smile and glamorous attire. Disarming means charming or attractive. At odds with means in disagreement with. And glamorous attire means a beautiful dress. And that something in her lifted on Monday, 22nd August 2005, to the world number one position in women's tennis. All this happened in almost no time. Poised beyond her years, the Siberian-born teenager took just 4 years as a professional to reach the pinnacle. Poised means calm, and pinnacle is highest level. However, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world began 9 years before with a level of sacrifice few children would be prepared to endure. Ascent means climb, and endure means tolerate. Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in the United States. That trip to Florida with her father, Yuri, launched her on the path to success and stardom. Stardom means popularity. But it also required a heart-wrenching 2-year separation from her mother, Yelena. Heart-wrenching means painful. The latter was compelled to stay back in Siberia because of visa restrictions. The 9-year-old girl had already learned an important lesson in life, that tennis excellence would only come at a price. When we talk about Maria Sharapova, there is some quality which is in contrast to her smile and her beauty, her glamour. And that quality makes her likable. Everybody likes her because she seems very charming. And it is this quality that helped her achieve success as she took on world number one position in women's tennis. She did that on 22nd of August 2005, which was Monday. Maria's calmness and elegance was beyond her age. She was just a teenager. She was born in Siberia, which is in Russia. And as a teenager, she took only 4 years of training to become this top woman tennis player. And that was appreciable. The fast growth of her career started 9 years ago when she made a big sacrifice, which can be made by very few children of her age. She had not even turned 10 when she was sent to Florida in USA with her father for training in tennis. She was extremely sad because her mother could not come with her since her mother did not get travel permit to US. So at that tender age of 9 years, Maria learned that in order to excel at tennis or in order to be the best in tennis, she would have to make many sacrifices. "I used to be so lonely," Maria Sharapova recalls. "I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going, so he couldn't see me either. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. The other tennis pupils would come in at 11 p.m. and wake me up and order me to tidy up the room and clean it." Pupils means students. "Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted. When you come from nothing and you have nothing, then it makes you very hungry and determined. I would have put up with much more humiliation and insults than that to steadfastly pursue my dream." Put up means tolerate. Humiliation means embarrassments, and steadfastly means determinedly. The toughness runs through Maria even today. It was the key to her bagging the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004. Bagging means achieving. And to her meteoric rise to the world number one spot the following year. Meteoric means fast. Maria recollects that she used to remain alone and missed her mother a lot. Her father worked hard to get money for her needs, and so he also could not meet her because he was busy in gaining money so that Maria could pursue her tennis training. Maria was very young, and so she would go to sleep at 8 p.m. The other students in that training institute would return at 11 and would wake her up, ordering her to clean the room. Maria did not get depressed by all this. Instead, she became determined and mentally tough. She took care of herself. She never thought of leaving the training because she was determined to achieve her aim. When a person has nothing, he craves, he wants more, and he becomes determined to get it. She says that she would have borne greater humiliation or insults also in order to achieve her dream. Maria still has that determination to the present day inside her, and this determination led her to grab the women's singles trophy at the Wimbledon Championship in 2004, followed by the rapid climb to the top position in 2005. While her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis has touched the hearts of tennis fans, for the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. Sentiment means emotion. The straight looks and the answers she gives when asked about her ambition make it amply clear that she considers the sacrifices were worth it. Amply clear means clear enough. "I am very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job." This is her mantra for success. Though Maria Sharapova speaks with a pronounced American accent, she proudly parades her Russian nationality. Clearing all doubts, she says, "I am Russian. It's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian. I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me." Maria is a Siberian. She belonged to Russia, and that place of Russia is very cold. So it is called as frozen plains of Siberia here in this paragraph. Now her journey from those frozen plains, that is from that cold area of Siberia, to the highest peak of her tennis career as the women's tennis player has always made her fans or tennis fans very emotional. But this kind of emotion is not there in Maria. As a youngster herself, she appears that she is not very emotional about her journey. She gives a very straight look whenever someone asks her about her ambition. And she clearly knows that if you want to achieve your aim or your goal, you got to make some sacrifices. And whatever sacrifices she made, she feels that they were worth it. She feels that she is very competitive. She can work hard at everything, and that is her job to do. And that's what she calls her mantra for success, or her secret of success. Now, though Maria Sharapova is a Russian citizen, she speaks in an American accent, but she proudly says that she is a Russian national because she has Russian citizenship. And if in future Russia allows her to play in Olympics, she is more than happy to do it. Like any number of teenage sensations, Maria Sharapova lists fashion, singing and dancing as her hobbies. She loves reading the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. Her fondness for sophisticated evening gowns appears at odds with her love of pancakes with chocolate spread and fizzy orange drinks. Sophisticated means elegant. Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. Pigeonholed means categorized. Her talent, unwavering desire to succeed, and readiness to sacrifice have lifted her to the top of the world. Unwavering means fixed. Few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. Grudge means hate. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. Monetary gains means the money that she is earning. Of course, money is a motivation. Tennis is a business and a sport. But the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That's the dream that kept me going. Like other teenagers of her age, Maria's favorite pastimes are fashion, singing, and dancing. She likes to read novels written by Arthur Conan Doyle. He is a writer who has also created Sherlock Holmes. She also likes to wear fashionable evening gowns. And looking at her fit body, it is unbelievable that she likes to eat pancakes with chocolate spread and drinks aerated orange flavored drinks. Maria cannot be put into a particular category. Her talent, urge to succeed and sacrificing nature helped her reach the top position in women's tennis. No one will oppose the benefits that she is getting now because she made many sacrifices to get them. And she says that money does motivate her to work hard. Tennis is both a sport and a business, but the most important aspect for her was to reach the top spot in women's tennis. It was this dream that kept her working further. The title Reach for the Top is very appropriate for this account of Maria Sharapova's journey as a top-class tennis player. This journey started with early training in her childhood and resulted in her becoming the number one in the world of tennis. The top symbolizes the highest point reached by her with courage and strong willpower. This chapter explains how she overcame all hardships and hurdles to reach the top. The chapter Reach for the Top conveys the message that one must set one's eyes on the stars and strive hard to achieve the goal through hard work, determination, and constant and persistent efforts. Instead of complaining against the ills in the society, one can dare to change the system and shape one's own destiny. It's time now for me to end my session with summary and question answers. I'll see you again in my next video with a new topic as usual. Till then, take good care of yourself. Love you all. God bless you and thank you very much.